What's up, everybody? It's Mr. Movie X Kicks, and as you can see, we have a special pink Jordan 6 edition coming up right after this. If you don't know, these are the Jordan 6 Aleli May editions. Ooh, these are nice. In hand, the Jordan 1 Aleli Mays that I did a couple months back. So I'm not gonna go in too much detail of who she is. Just know that she is a dope stylist. Like I said, I'm gonna put the link in the description. So if you guys really want to go back and see who she is, I did a whole little segment of her with a video and everything, describing her past, where she's from, and how she's done things up to this point. But this is her. This is her third rendition of the Jordan, and she's actually. Because if you really think about it, a lot of women do not get their own Jordan shoes. If I'm not mistaken, I want to say there's maybe three women that I know of off the top of my head. But this is fire. This actually came out last week, March 14th, I think, or March 14th, March 15th was the release date. Now, these are her third renditions. Now, she did a first Jordan 1 that is still at one of the best colorways that she probably, in my opinion, will probably ever come out. It was for men and women. It's still selling for almost between $500 to $600. Then her second one, to me, which I thought was her best shoe, was a Jordan 1 who I did the review of as well. That's actually my most viewed that's my most viewed video, so go figure. And this is her third rendition of the Jordan 6. And a couple months prior, this was the Jordan Infrared 6s. So to come out again basically in an all women's colorway, it was a nice little touch. Now, one thing you can't notice, like I said, in pictures, that's why I get stuff in person. There's a lot of small details that I didn't really realize in this shoe until you get it. I thought this was kind of like an all leather or just kind of plastic shoe. This is actually a all suede, kind of just like the Jordan 6s, the Infrared 6s. But like I said, and I love the small little details of the addness. Besides the pink suede, the upper part is kind of like a suede, a satin in the front, and kind of also once you look in the tip of the tongue, or once you go in the inner lining of the shoe, it's an all kind of satin, light pink satin feel. An all pink satin in the inside of the sole, which I wasn't expecting. And it's kind of hard to see the inside, you know, on pictures on the internet. You know, to get these in person to see, I'm like, I love how this kind of satin feels and looks. It looks very nice. As the back of the shoe, you look, it's the Jordan logo, the Air Jump Jordan logo, instead of the traditional almost Nike. So I'm not for sure exactly why they went with the all Jumpman logo instead of the Nike logo. I'm not for sure if that is, you know, more expensive, maybe. I think the Air Nike logo probably would have been a nice touch to it. I think that it made a little difference, especially being on a women's shoe. And especially with this being an exclusive women's shoe, I think adding the Nike on the back would have been a nice little touch to add and make it more of a sneaker head kind of cop, just because it had that iconic Nike logo on the back. So I'm not 100% sure why they didn't just, like I said, put the Jumpman logo instead of the Nike logo. But these are pretty much almost just exactly like the Infrared 6s. Now, a good little info about these shoes is these shoes were actually released a couple years ago, but they were only friends and family. And I love the bottom of these shoes. As you see, like from the original Jordan 6s that came out a couple months ago from the Infrared 6s, they had an icy blue bottom, but these ones have just a kind of a creamy white bottom with the Infrared Jordan Jumpman logo, which I liked it. I like the icy blue logo. I like the icy cream bottom. So I like that touch, and it hits with the infrared on the side. I just love, like, this is a dope shoe. And unfortunately, like I said, it is a women's shoe, so this is actually a size 12. I haven't even tried it on. I hope it fits. I wear 10.5 in men, so and that really translates to a 12 in women, so I hope it fits. That would be unfortunate if it didn't. So, but like I said, these were released last Friday, and the retail price was $190 after tax, probably around $215. They were limited to the sneaker app and a couple other specialty shops. For the most part, you can only get these on sneaker apps. Now, the reselling for these before they came out were extremely high. I'm talking about, I've seen a pair going for like, you know, almost like $1,000 plus. Yes. Only bad thing about trying to get a woman's shoe is that most men know that, you know, if you want, like me, like if you want a 12 or a 13 or a 14 or any big sizes, the prices are going to go extremely high, you know, because they know that the guys are going to want these for themselves to try them on like myself. So they're going to stick you for these prices. So as of right now, the prices have gone down a little bit because they were released. And I think this one took me a while to get. I got this off StockX. Thanks, StockX, for authenticating these bad boys. Now, apparently, a lot of the big sizes, maybe, like I said, I got these before they released. Like, about, I got these the Monday before they released, and they just got here, so it took them a week. But apparently, the only, I'm guessing, the only big sizes were overseas, because these were from London. So I was like, oh, that's why it took so long to get here. So I'm guessing only the big sizes are, I guess, were mainly overseas. Now, like I said, these weren't limited. I think they did go up to a, they did go up to a 13, and I think the 13 is the biggest, a 13 or a 14, but those are almost, prices are like almost like, you know, almost $2,000, because like I said, the bigger the size in the women's shoe, the bigger the price tag is going to be. But as of right now, the retail for the bigger prices are sitting between, like, I want to say between $400 and $700. Like I said, size 12 now is running between like $450 to like $500, which isn't a bad resale. To me, I think her best shoe still should have been that Jordan, her last Jordan shoe. I just thought that was a dope shoe with the detachable fur. I just think a lot of people slept on that shoe. And it's now, the good thing I like about this shoe is it doesn't come with that traditional Jordan 6 box. This one, we've seen this box before. If you've gotten the Michigan 12s or the Derek Jeter Lowe's, this box came with it. But I do like this box better. It's just more, to me, more unique box. Like I said, it's nothing I haven't seen before, but I do like this box. And now that I have it, I'm going to keep it. But with that said, this was just a nice little overview. Like I said, I love this shoe. It was an exclusive shoe. Like I said, man, if you're trying to get these shoes, I'd say go up, you know, like I said, try to get the 12 if you're a 10 and a half. You know, everyone can break down the charts of seating. Everyone can break down the charts of sizing, and if you want to get these bad boys. So drop me some comments. Tell me what you guys think of these Alele May 6s. Do you think these are a good colorway, or you think they were a pass? Now, they did sell out in about 4 minutes on a sneaker app, which is pretty good. Like I said, guys, drop me some comments. Tell me what you guys think about these bad boys. And I am going to shoot some on feet for you guys, per usual. As always, guys, please subscribe. I'm up to almost 180 followers. Excuse me, I'm up to almost 180 subscribers. My goal for the end of the month is to get to 200, so I'm almost there. So, as always, guys, please thank you for subscribing, and please drop me some comments. Tell me what you guys think about these shoes. And I have a couple other shoe reviews coming up as well, and the Us movie review that I cannot wait to go see. I'm seeing it on Thursday, so expect that from me this weekend as well. All right, guys, I'll holler at you later. Mr. Movie X Kicks is out.